Strength and conditioning expert Brandon Krause. He works with NBA players, he works with NFL stars. He's also a boxing trainer, and he's also a person that's very knowledgeable about the mechanics of the human body. So one thing in the Olympics that's very popular is the heavy lifting. Brandon, what's the right way to lift? What's the wrong way? How do these people not get injured by lifting 600 pounds, 400 pounds?
Sure, Olympic lifting is great, and it's become very in vogue as far as cross-training for other sports has gone, because it is an all-encompassing lifts to produce maximum force, maximum explosiveness. And yes, these Olympic lifters have known that for decades, but now other sports are starting to bridge the gap and include these lifts.
Why?
Well, because it follows the kinetic chain. It is total body. It is functional in nature. The power that you gain from these type of lifts can easily be spread into other athletic avenues. So let's talk about these lifts. It's basically three different lifts: the deadlift, the clean and press, and the snatch. So the deadlift we'll start with. That's basically going from the ground to a hanging position, locking out. What they do, and what you'll notice them doing in the Olympics, is with this over-under grip, where one hand goes over the top, one hand goes under. Well, I only have 25 pounds on each side here, so it doesn't really matter about this grip, but when you have 800, 1,000 pounds on here, that's gonna be basically the only grip that you can pull enough strength out and still keep that darn thing in your hands. So I keep my heels down, I get that over-under grip, I make sure I'm looking up, I don't arch my back, I try to stay looking up, and I use my legs, my glutes, and my hamstrings to lock me out in this position. Once the official tells me that it's a good lift, I can just drop that weight and be done. So that's what you'll notice, that they'll lift, 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 and there'll be a judge telling them good lift or telling them faulty lift, and that's how they know if they've progressed. So now let's progress. Let's get into the clean and the press. Now this one's gonna come from the ground, and it's gonna end up in the top of my chest. That'll be the first half of the move. And then I have like a brief period to kind of regroup until I can try to get that thing over my head. I'm gonna go over grip, because eventually it is gonna go over my head. So first thing, gonna start with that same technique as the deadlift, but I'm gonna continue up to the top of my chest. Now from here, I'm gonna stagger on my feet and throw this over my head. Good lift, they tell me. Boom. Drop the weight, and then hopefully move on to the next size that I'm going after. That's how they do. They'll pick the weights that they want to try to do in a particular session, and I think they'll add up their entire weights. The most explosive and the final lift that we're going to do is the snatch. Very difficult technique, something that's going to take you years and years to master. And basically, I'm going to throw this weight over my head. And again, I'm only doing 95 pounds, which is plenty of weight for me. These guys in the Olympic lifting are doing 400, 500, 600 pounds, throwing that up their head. So anyways, the approach is similar. Really close, looking up, no arch in my back. This one I'm gonna go a little bit wider on my grip, because it's gonna end up reaching behind me a little bit after I've thrown it up. They tell me good lift. We're done.
Did the guys, I know they get tested in the Olympics like crazy, but half of the dudes look like they're juiced up. Like there's no humanly possible way to lift 800, 600, or 700 pounds.
Well,
can they do it?
There's extremely strong people out there. Also, bear in mind that these people are giant. Yeah, look, all sports. Performance-enhancing drugs is part of the modern athlete, unfortunately. And I couldn't tell you just by looking at somebody if they were on the juice or not. And I would love to say that none of these athletes in the greatest sporting event ever, the Olympics, is taking performance-enhancing drugs. But we know that's not the truth. We know that they get busted all the time, and especially Olympic lifters. And sometimes they do it in techniques of taking it, you know, well before the testing period, or taking designer drugs that are impossible to test for. But look, I'm just going to hold truth to the beauty of sport, and hopefully every one of these fine athletes that I watch on TV starting at the end of the month is clean and doing this just for the love of the sport. But that's not the world we live in.
There you have it. Stay tuned. Brandon Krause from the Outlaws Box Club in Tarzana, FASBReporting.com, and my Sickback Reporting. And you can follow me on Twitter, @Sickback.